Oh, yeah. Dude, do you remember the 80s?
I was born in the 80s, yes.
Do you remember 80s cartoons?
Mostly, that's all I remember from the 80s, yeah.
80s cartoons had some banger intros, folks.
They did, yeah, they did.
So how about this? Let's watch them, go through them, and we'll rate each one of them on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being poo-poo and 10 being excellent, totally rad.
So when you say, like, ranking them, is it by, like, hypeness or most uniqueness, like, or just overall feel?
I don't know. What do you think the criteria should be? I guess whichever one makes you, I guess, pog the hardest.
What makes you pog the hardest?
What makes you want to watch it the most?
Okay.
Like, I think we can all agree already, Thundercats is a 10.
Thunder. Oh, yeah.
Thundercats a 10. I don't know what a 1 looks like, but we're going to find out pretty soon.
We're rating just the intro, not the show.
Just the intro.
That's different, right?
Does the intro make you want to watch the cartoon? It's a pog scale. How much do you pog? Can we watch Yu Yu Hakusho, says Mr. Insane. It's probably on here. We're not going to get through all of them, okay?
There's too many.
There's 4 hours, okay? But we're going to start. We're going to start chipping away at it. James Bond Jr.
Might
be a 1. I don't know.
I've seen that intro and it sucks.
Let's find out.
But I'll let the chat decide.
Let's begin.
Warning to all living mortals that whosoever opens this chest of demons will release 13 of the most terrifying ghosts upon the face of the earth.
Yo, this is clapping for a Scooby-Doo. Who the hell's that?
It's that man.
Let's get him, Bogle.
Who the hell's this?
I'm a witch, weird.
Is this like a super compilation show?
Vincent Price.
That cartoon Vincent Price.
I'm a green Vincent Price.
Yeah,
little
boy. For a second, I was like, wait, is this the
plane? It's the Toto. The plane.
the man on the phone.
The Scooby-Doo.
The demons to the chest.
Yo, there's like 20 Scooby-Dooses. There's a lot of Scooby-Dids. He did it. Scooby-Dun dude did it all.
Got his marketing out there. Damn.
Whoa. Who's this other kid hanging out with Scrappy? Oh, you got Vincent Price laughing in your intro. It's good.
The 13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo.
What are you giving that one, chat?
First one's always hard to kind of gauge because it's like, how do we pog from here on out?
I know. It's Scooby-Doo, and Scooby-Doo's original intro is so good. I don't know who the fuck these two guys are.
They're not very original.
I don't know who the little kid is. Where's the other guy? Where's the other lady?
Is that, and that's like half Daphne, half the other lady.
Yeah, they like combined it.
Velma or whatever.
Yeah, I'm going to go with it. But you got, I was going to give it like a 5 out of 10, but you have Vincent Price laughing. It's going to be a 6.4.
For me, it was a solid 6. Vincent Price was the only thing that really got me. Scooby-Doo.
Rookie score. I know everybody's doing this right now. I know everybody's doing this, dude. I don't even know if it was a great show, but the intro just makes you start.
Great example of a dog shit show with an awesome fucking banger of an intro.
It's banging. It makes you want to watch. Was it actually good?
No, it sucked.
I mean, it was a youngin', you know? But I remember having this on, this intro, just...
Like, this is an era of, like, cartoons where, like, just make them kids. It's the same show, just make them kids.
There's a few tricks you could do to keep a series going. Age everybody up or age them down.
Oh, Rugrats.
And you got a full new show.
Oh, Rugrats.
Because you already worked out these characters and their archetypes.
9, the only thing holding it back is it's Scooby-Doo, dude.
Scooby-Doo claps. What are you talking
about? Scooby-Doo's a bitch, dude.
All right, with your fucking Ninja Turtle shirt. I'm going to give it, I got to be fair. Okay, I can't start giving rookie scores here. I'm going to give it like a 9.3.
8.7.
Okay. I'm not giving rookie scores.
What do we do?
Oh, Canadian TV.
Filmation?
Got older. I learned a lot.
What are we giving this one? Chat, really, you know, just give it a score, you know, just give it a score. I just want to see what the chat says. Let me see your numbers. Wow, zeros and tens. Combining the real life dude with the cartoon was always strange to see.
Yeah.
But it wasn't even Roger Rabbity. It was just he's there.
Also, Bill Cosby back then means so much something different now. But I have to judge it through my lens now.
Mm-hmm.
Realistically, that intro kind of sucked ass.
I honestly want to give it like a 3.3 because it doesn't even show like how good the cartoon was like at all. It's kind of just, here's Bill Cosby. You love Bill Cosby. Well, back then you did. And here he is. And here's his thing. And he's on it. And he's a part of it. Whereas like the actual cartoon clapped.
Yeah.
But it doesn't really show it off too much.
The best part was when the hand goes into the camera, goes,
it was cool.
And that is just a hand pointing in the camera.
My score is mostly just, come on, you got to show off how cool the actual cartoon is. You're just promoting this guy. Just, and I get it. He's, you know.
It's just Bill Cosby stirring orange paint. I guess.
Yeah. Like, I feel like I'm going to watch.
It's all over. It's just Bill Cosby.
I feel like I'm going to watch Bill Cosby paint. I'm not going to watch a cool cartoon.
I'm not pogging.
Look at him.
Sus, bro. Mad sus. He's literally venting. He's venting right now.
I was going to say, look at him, dude. He's out there. He's looking around. Watch out, chat. He's going to get you.
Oh.
Oh. Some of these are going to be rough. I'm already scared of this one.
Oh, Raggedy Ann. And Andy. Maybe it's Pog.
Maybe it gets better.
Maybe it pogs.
Hold on. It might get really good.
Oh, yo, look at that cat.
Literal anchor. What up, dude? Look at the what?
Look at the cat. I'm assuming that's a cat or cat. A rodent or some sort.
Bro, Annabelle. Bro, it's Annabelle.
Annabelle.
The Care Bear guy who's not a Care Bear.
Headless Horseman's Pog.
Okay.
Did it kill him into a vortex of hell? Wait, what the fuck is this thing about?
Yo, why is Raggedy Ann on like a dope-ass quest? What the fuck is like Zelda?
A witch!
Raggedy Ann and Andy. It went pretty lame, but then it got real sick, dude.
It went Dungeons and Dragons.
It turned into like Zelda.
Yeah.
Toy Story ripped this off. It's exactly right, dude. Chat, what are you going to give it? Chat, what's the score? This one, I mean, don't like Raggedy Ann at all.
Nor Andy.
But you took me on like a quest? You're going to take me on like a quest? We're going on like a quest? I'm going to say 4.5.
The music sucked ass. It was very farty.
It's farty.
There was a wizard and a dragon, I think. Four.
We're fours on this one. We rating the music. You're rating the whole. Does the intro make you pog? You know, 10 is. Oh, I'm pogging. I want to watch it right now. I'm gonna boot it up on YouTube right now.
So I think we can all agree the X-Men intro, the cartoon.
10.
It's amazing, right?
Makes you want to watch it.
You just have to play the music and you're pogging.
Thundercat, 10.
You see what I'm saying? When it's the perfect amalgamation of everything.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea what the fuck this is.
Look at this guy.
Oh.
A thunder of jets in an open sky, a streak of gray and a cheerful.
Oof. God, it's just so old.
Yeah, I learned what depression was at a young age whenever I saw this intro.
That's so old. Hold on, let's give it a chance.
A whirl and a vertical climb, and once again, you'll know it's time for the adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle and friends.
And?
A double and run-on?
This is like a spin-off. Oh, so many ands.
Oh, man.
Starring that supersonic speedster, Rocket J. Squirrel. with his pal Bullwinkle the Moose.
Oof.
And a host of others.
Yeah.
Those Nazis.
The Nazi guy.
Hurry, Bullwinkle.
Oh, that voice.
Hurry, Bullwinkle.
Are they at the JFK parade?
Oh, no. The Nazi guy.
Hurry up, Bullwinkle. We're going to miss the parade.
Oh, no.
I'm coming as fast as I can.
We're in the front of the chain.
Look out of the way, Bullwinkle. I'm going to get over you.
Oh, yeah. He talks like this.
Oh, yes.
Yay.
Now what are you doing?
Signing autographs.
What are you doing?
Signing autographs.
Let's see. Tom Smith.
But I can't understand a fucking word you're saying.
Jesus fucking Christ, Bullwinkle.
Your
what the fuck?
Name is Bullwinkle.
I know, but that's hard to spell.
It's hard to spell.
Oh, God. That's the intro! That is the intro, dude!
I'm giving that a 1.2.
So you're a kid. It's Saturday morning. You're like, yeah, cartoons! And then that plays, you're like, what the?
I'm giving that a 1.2. Aqualung 10, yeah.
What?
Depression, the cartoon. Very slow. Boring.
God. I don't even know how to spell my own name.
It makes me feel like there's like dust in my eyes by walking. What's your score?
One.
Hold on, let me turn it up because this is going somewhere.
I feel like it's gonna kick up.
I feel
a little
like
bit.
It's about to get crazy. Oh my God, it's getting weird, all right. Hold on, it's getting weird, dude.
Hey, I accept all forms of love. I think love is a beautiful thing. I don't judge people. I think it's great.
Come drink with me tonight. Come drink with me tonight. Let's go to far off places and search for treasures.
Ah, fuck you guys.
With me tonight.
Yes!
Oh my God!
Come with me tonight,
guys. I'm bathing in the waterfall. It's great.
Let's build a giant.
I don't know. I'm from Nebraska. I don't know how I got up here, but I'm here to stay.
All I'll say is be careful drinking that rainbow water.
The fumes coming out for that.
Airship and sail into the sky. Let's watch the birds as they fly by.
Oh, well. Oh, well.
Fly so high.
Oh, this is...
Come dream with me tonight.
Inspector Gadget. Eddie Ruxpin.
Oh, Ruxpin.
Yo. You want to take me on an adventure?
Tonight.
I'll be coming all night, baby.
Come with me tonight.
What are you giving that one, chat?
That was pretty awesome.
I don't think so.
There's no way, like, compare that to the Bullwinkle thing.
Bullwinkle's a one. This is like a fucking...
Stay with me tonight.
I'm giving it a two.
Whoa, you hated it?
I didn't like it at all.
I loved it.
Do you want to watch the cartoon?
Absolutely not. That fucking bug, dude. That dude's fucking weird, man.
Song sucked, dude. It had potential, and that was like a weird bug, dude, making out with a bear, and then some guy bathing in rainbows, and some old guy's just there.
So,
I don't know.
Stay with me tonight.
I'm giving it like a 2 or 3. What are you giving?
7.2.
Oh my God. Everybody's score is different.
In 2018,
this looks pog.
Two peaceful aliens journeyed to Earth, seeking our help.
Well, oh yeah, I was looking at
they
dubbing this show.
For our first hyperdrive, allowing mankind to open the doors to the stars.
Whoa, I've never seen this.
We have assembled a team of unique individuals
what?
To protect
yes.
Earth and
yeah,
our
I was
allies.
Watching this.
Courageous pioneers committed to the highest ideals of justice.
What?
And dedicated to preserving law.
It's like full episodes on YouTube of this.
And order across the new frontier. These are the adventures.
Look at the fucking, oh, I love how handcrafted the title cards would be. Adventures on a Ribbon of the Galaxy Rangers.
So It's Walker Texas Ranger, but in space?
And like Guardians of the Galaxy cowboy team.
Galaxy Ranger.
Hands on his hips. Is...
Galaxy Rangers! Whoa!
I would turn it up more, but I can't.
Yo, Kylo Ren! Boss the hothead.
Then there's the hot guy. He's got the hot guns. Galaxy Rangers. Dude. It collapsed. Dude.
Hey, that was. I want to know more about it. It had like anime.
I'm agreeing with you, chat. Hard tens. I don't know about hard 10, but I'm definitely going 9.
8.9.
9. I'm going 9.
Only because I felt like the music could have been better. It was rocking.
Dude, it was good.
But it wasn't like.
Dude, it was so good. Oh boy.
Oh boy. Are we allowed to even show this? This might be it.
Dashing and daring, courageous and caring, faithful and friendly with stories to share.
It is Disney, huh? I should be more careful, shouldn't I?
Yeah, I mean, we can do an acapella version of it.
Do I have any? I don't think I have any whimsical stuff that'll kind of fit this.
Any butt rock? Yeah. Gummy bears, we're gonna take you anywhere.
Gummy bears, baby, jumping down, jumping around, yeah.
No, nice.
Oh, Hydra.
Fucking Hydra, dude.
Fuck.
Gummy bears and reading books, magic scrolls and drinking gummy juice.
Oh, she gets turned up.
They're not the Care Bears, baby. They're the Gummy Bears. They don't care, baby. They're made of gummies. Everybody's jumping around, down, bouncing on their dummy thick butts.
Ugh. I remember watching this one, and it's a rough show, you know? It's like Care Bears, but it's not as colorful.
So you
a
know
little bit more adventure.
So you know what you think to yourself when you're watching Gummy Bears?
Mm-hmm.
Why am I not watching Tailspin?
Yeah, it's actually true.
And you're like, God damn, it's not Tailspin.
The music is sick, though, if they didn't have to copyright
Gummy
claim
bears.
Us. It's good, dude.
Bears.
It's a good theme song, though. If we're going on intros, it's a shame I can't play it.
Really. I can't remember anything about the show. I only know the intro.
The music is everything here. Damn, you hear his like own backup vocal he did in the back going.
Here and there and everywhere.
You know, we're going off of intro, and music is a part of it.
Yeah.
So, dude, honestly, with this song.
Growing, they take pride in knowing they'll fight for what's right. Whatever they do, gummy bears.
Ooh.
Gummy bears.
Yo, I'm going to have to give it like a fucking 7.5.
What the visuals are going on doesn't really sell me. I'm going to say 6. The music is fucking really
music's good.
Though.
If there's a skip in the footage, then VOD gang, you know what happened.
Yeah.
The mouse got us.
Boys from down under in the chat. Who can maybe chime in on if this is good or dog shit, bruv?
Bruv? Where the Aussies at, eh? Where the Koala Boys at, eh?
Oh, I bloody love this show.
You what? Grab a didgeridoo and let's have a good time.
Those aliens. Oh, they are aliens.
Wait.
Is this anime?
How pog is this? Is this based on Hello Kitty shit?
Oh, is this the Hello Kitty dude?
It is, isn't it? It's like the same company.
Oh, like the same universe, right?
It's anime. Oh, the song's garbage.
Oof, it's bad.
Song sucks.
Oh, I'm from Australia, isn't it? And I've never seen this show.
Bloody good show.
Us. For me, solid three.
Three.
Solid three.
Three.
Wait, I didn't even know this existed.
Now listen here, folks. My name is Tom Sawyer. I don't want to be no doctor or no lawyer.
Tom Sawyer.
Fishing by the river, that's the only place to be.
Tom Sawyer, the anime? Wow, they will make anything anime.
I want to be free.
It's not anime. But...
sitting under a tree, that's me.
Ew.
Oof. Rough.
It is anime. It's anime, dude.
Dude, if you told them one day your book is going to be an anime.
I dare say, what is this anime you speak of, young fella?
Turning in my grave.
These are the stories of Tom Sawyer.
How weird to see Tom Sawyer as an anime. That is bizarre. Yeah, it's almost Studio Ghibli-ish. Almost, huh?
Oh, God. What?
What's wrong with her? Yeah, Ghibli. Your chili poodle and cannon fodder.
Is it Miyazaki?
Incredibly boring.
This looks so bad. And
it's another, like, it's another, like, two. No, one.
It's like, oh, like, you pulled this VHS up when you're like, oh, I had to do a book report on Tom Sawyer and I didn't read it. Mm-hmm. And you pull this up and you're like, fuck, I wish I read it.
This looks bad.
Ugh.
This looks real bad. All new Popeye.
What's your rank for the Tom Sawyer?
Yeah, I give it a two. No, one, two. A one, and one.
Two.
A one. Let's see Popeye. New Popeye.
What?
Popeye, no. I know of him. I know what he does. I know his thing, but I never really watched Popeye.
I never got the appeal of Popeye.
Popeye.
I'm strong to the finish, cause I eat...
Oh, yeah, sounds awful.
Eat my spinach.
And then Family Guy made fun of his arms.
I'll get you.
He kicks ass, he was dope, he clapped.
But what did he do?
He's a sailor man.
Okay.
And then this guy fucks with him, and then he eats his, he eats his, like, sensu beans, and he fucking, yeah, Coolidge, he fucking beats his ass every episode, and then he gets olive oil all over him. He gets olive oil's oil all over him.
Oh.
And they go to space.
But...
in the Navy.
You know?
It's a big anchor in his pants.
What's going on there?
This is the intro?
This is the intro to the...
intro's the show. It's already playing the show.
Jesus Christ!
I'm strong to the finish, cause I eat fish spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Oh, his existence looks painful, huh?
Yeah, what the fuck is going on with Popeye?
Like, it looks painful to be him. Like, he looks like he's in pain.
I desperately need to see a doctor.
I only eat spinach. I'm very malnutritious.
Oh, God, my nose is caving into my chin. I can barely breathe.
I've been smoking cigarettes and...
You almost have to make his face to do the voice.
Fuck, that sucks so bad, dude. Popeye is trash. Popeye is dog shit. It's never been good.
You guys might be holding on to some fond memories of him. What are you going to give this out of 10, the intro? I'm going to give it a... some of you guys going 5. Man, some of you guys drop hard 10s. It's got to be nostalgia, huh?
You gave this a 6?
A 6?
A 6 people for this?
People like their Popeye. I got to take into consideration how low Tom Sawyer being a 1. I'm going to make this like a 4. This is a 4.
I think a 4 is way too generous, dude.
Tom Sawyer 1. So what's this? This is right there with Tom Sawyer anime?
With 3.
Koala anime? 3. It's people got nostalgia. I get it. Whoa, hey. Hold on. What's going on? Okay.
All right. Yes!
I haven't heard these voices in so long.
You know what? Whenever I'm looking at like band appeals in our community, this is the voice I put in the band appeal. Like, hey, why am I banned?
What did I do?
What did I do so wrong?
I'm not racist.
Jesus Christ, you guys are a bunch of snowflakes.
You guys need to fucking lighten up.
Can't take a joke, huh?
Not fucking racist. It's 2021, bitch.
Whatever. Oh, he's surfing in a tub, dude.
Dude, he's hanging 10 in a tub.
And they're filming.
He's blowing wind. This is for his Tinder profile.
Oh, yeah, and then they try to, like, impress, like, real people.
Yeah, because
right.
They were always hanging out with that guy, Alvin. The voice does get pretty annoying after a little bit, though.
Oh, it's just terrible.
It's cool for the first 2 seconds. You're like, all right.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
Oh, they're harmonizing with it? Oof. Okay.
Oh, Theodore.
Man, that voice is so fucked.
Chat, what are you giving Alvin? What's Alvin and the Chipmunks getting? Glad it's over. Can I unmute the stream now? Dude, it's pretty rough with the voice. It's pretty rough with the voices. I'm going to give it like a fucking 3 because it's
four.
Rough. A four. 3 or 4. It was,
I'd rather watch that than Popeye.
Popeye the 3 and this can take the 4. The voices, yeah.
So bad.
Ugh. You were vibing?
$1 million. I wouldn't even know for what to spend. I don't want to be a football hero.
Wait, is this racist?
I don't know.
I only want to be your friend. Buenos dias, amigo. Buenos dias, amigo. I don't want to be a movie actor. No, no.
What?
I don't want the country to be thin. I don't want to be your president. I only want to be your friend. Hey, amigo.
Amigo.
It's trying to be inclusive, but also racist at the same time.
He's like, I don't want to fight. I just want to be your friend. I don't want any trouble. I just want to be your friend.
What? A friends and friends.
Friend
yeah.
And friend and friends.
Friend and friends.
People say, what are you going to give it? You're going to give it a no mama's way out of 10?
No. No mamas. No mamas out of 10.
You're giving it no mamas
no
out of 10.
No comprehendo, dude.
No mamas out of 10.
That's the truth, amigo.
What?
He's friends with everybody.
He's friends with every stereotype.
It's the 80s. Astro Boy.
I've never seen an Astro Boy intro.
Yo, let's check. Let's peep this.
And wise and
brave
smart
and gentle and smart
fun.
So stronger than all the rest. This tiny robot will pass the
test. Fucking Mega Man, dude.
Keeps going.
Our robot friend is their people.
He's fighting giant spider robots.
Butt laser?
Butt laser.
I know I had butt lasers.
Finger lasers? Mega Man before Mega Man was Mega Man.
Oh, that's awesome. He's strong.
I feel like no word rhymes in the song.
Yeah, it's just like words. It's like, who, what, where, and why?
What?
pretty good. The song didn't rhyme at all. It was a little off key in a few parts there, but then that riff at the end brought it home. What are you going to give non-Mega Man? What are you going to give pre-Mega Man out of 10?
So I think like this is kind of like a rose-colored glasses type situation where it's like it's Astro Boy. So you have to like, you have to pog because it's Astro Boy. But
Astro Boy.
I don't know what Astro Boy does.
It's Astro Boy. He's Mega Man.
And the song was bad. That was not a good song.
Damn, Kenny giving it a brutal.
I thought it was pretty low tier myself.
Brutal three.
The butt laser was pretty pog.
I'm going to give him, you would turn the TV off. I'm giving it a five then. I'm going to give it a five.
And this is like people's like first introduction to anime, right?
Yeah.
Pretty bad.
He's getting a five.
I was going to say four.
We're starting off like touching and sad on the intro. No? Getting good?
What?
Who the...
What is this?
What the...
Poorilla?
Curious Poorilla? The fuck is this? Babar?
Who?
Oh my god, Chad knows what it is. That's Babar. Oh, Babar. Who's Babar? I've never seen this.
Babar fucks?
The animation's like really smooth.
Who's this? Wait, did she...
Reminds me of like Rupert.
Yeah.
Very like mature.
Is this European?
Babar. Did we not have it? I don't know if we had it.
I did not see
French.
This.
French cartoon.
That's why it's so awkward.
French Canadian. It's like, I feel like we're watching more of like a Hallmark card commercial.
I feel like I'm gonna fall asleep, man.
Hallmark. Spend the holidays.
Here, Babar, here, read this book.
I don't have fingers. It's hard to open it. He's a king. Based on the characters created by Naaman, Laurent, and Barfafoff.
Yo, that was boring.
It's for kids. It's for kids. Animation was like pretty top tier for how smooth they were moving. They were like,
yeah.
They were animated up the butt.
But why? What of that intro made you want to watch Babar?
It's wholesome. It's not for me. It's for children. I get that. So I'm just trying to base it on its own thing, its own category. It's not trying to appeal to 40-year-old pops.
Okay.
So just basing it off of
so
a warm Hallmark children's
intro. If I was an 8-year-old again and I saw somebody. Like,
yeah.
What the fuck
channel
is
8-year,
this?
Channel 5, channel 4-year-old year old pops. Now what do you give it?
Oof, man, I'm just so bored and so just not interested. Like, they're reading...
Exactly,
like,
it's still low.
They're reading books. Like, the last thing I want to do in cartoons is read books, dude. I want to see fucking laser beams and claws and fucking rock and roll guitar, man. Not...
Reading books. In animation, you can do anything. You can be anywhere. You can fight any monster, go to any planet, do anything. And they're reading books in a study.
With an old lady.
Oh, gosh. It's not even like a rockin' hot hairband chick.
It's an old lady. I made ginger snaps.
Babar.
For you, Babar.
These ginger snaps are a day old.
Babar. It's a proper cartoon, people are saying.
Ugh.
It's a proper cartoon.
Well, judging it on the intro only, might be an awesome show.
Five.
Intro, I think it was lovely and warm. I'm going to give it a six.
Reading Rainbow has a pog intro.
Oh my god, that's
Reading
a 10.
Rainbow
that's a
made
10.
Me want to read books.
That's a 10.
You see what I'm saying? That
does
the opposite effect of this.
This is not a 10. But it was warm and wholesome. And the animation was top tier. Even though they're fucking doing boring shit that you don't
I mean,
need.
They have dots for eyes.
Yeah. This is 29 Acacia Road. And this is Eric. The schoolboy who leads an amazing...
Look, it's Chet. Hey, guys, check out my gamer rig.
This dude loves bananas.
Oh, my God, he's got a banana bed, banana clock, banana's hand, banana watch, banana picture.
Is this Banana Sam? Who the fuck
banana
is
man?
This?
Banana man.
When Eric eats a banana, an amazing transformation occurs. Eric is Banana Man.
Oh, my God. What the fuck is this, dude?
Ever alert for the call to action.
What is he doing?
Banana Fingers.
Yo, oh Banana Man. God, Banana Man's awesome.
Yo, Banana Man.
Yo, Banana Man fucks.
Welcome to the club. Banana Man's in the club, dude.
Yo, invite Banana Man to the picnic.
That's a 10. That's a 10.
I don't even know, need to know anything.
You don't. You already got it.
I got it.
Simple as could be.
I buy one, Banana Man.
Eric.
Yo, Banana Man for Smash.
Yo, where was Banana Man for Smash? Come on, Sakurai. It was banana feet? His banana fingers?
His banana fingies?
He's going to break it his back.
Woo! Ooh, poke it out, Banana Man.
That banana ass. Oh, his cape is like two peels.
Yo, banana cake.
Where was Banana Man for everything? Where has he been our whole lives? Banana Man.
Banana Man was gangster.
Where's the Banana Man Pixar adaptation?
True.
Bring him into the Marvel Universe. Let's fucking go, dude.
Yeah, like we need the Banana Man origin story where he meets Shang-Chi and stuff.
Let's do Banana Man and the X-Men.
Yeah.
Come on. Whoa. We're getting loud here. God, those orchestras don't sound like that no more, huh?
Yeah.
So warm and
true.
Grand. Hey, it's picking up.
Sandy Frank presents
Battle of the Planets.
Yes!
What? Whoa!
Awesome!
Yo, I've seen these characters in something
before. These are like the Capcom versus Tetsunoke or something like that.
Yeah, Capcom did a fighting game with these guys.
Right? Or
gotcha,
am I wrong?
Man? Gotcha, man. Gotcha, man. Tetsunoko.
Right?
I think some Japanese companies owns these characters.
G-Force. Five incredible young people with superpowers.
Yeah, that dude. Yeah, he's in that game.
And watching over them from Center Neptune, Seven Zark Seven.
Oh, is he talking?
Seven Zark Seven. He's beeping. He's booping.
Okay.
Watching, warning against surprise attack by alien galaxies from beyond space.
Beyond space?
This looks cool.
Space stuff.
Sank Sam? I didn't get his name either. I don't know. Anytime you have a team and they all wear like a Power Ranger-y thing, it's like we're all in.
Yeah, it's good merchandise, right?
Fuck yes, dude. Easy to follow. I know what's going on. I get it. I got it. Looks dope. Gamer Girl, have you guys stretched your back and drank water?
Shit.
Oh, my bones popped.
Yo, they got like synchronized, moves. But they themselves fly. Whoa, panties!
G-Force, fearless young orphans.
Yo, who do they fight? I want to see the bad guy.
Protecting Earth's entire galaxy. Always five, acting as one. Dedicated. Oh!
This intro's nuts.
It's pretty epic.
Yo, Robots and Gods Band, thank you for the tier 3, dude.
Hell yeah!
Thank you, dude.
Full year, man. Thank you, dude.
Invincible.
You're the man.
Thank you. Pretty awesome.
Dude, that was a long intro, and it was super dope, and they look cool. They look like Power Rangers, but, like, fucking cool. I don't know. They look cool as shit. It goes on.
It's a little long in the tooth.
And that guy's very, it's the greatest thing in the universe, and it's the best. It's a bit long, so I'm going to give it like an 8.
7.4.
I'll give it an 8. Chat, what are you guys giving? Sevens, nines, sixes, eights? I say some eights. Oh, shit. We're going into
Beetlejuice cartoon.
Beetlejuice.
The animation's pretty cool.
That first frame.
That's animated really cool.
Yeah.
Yo, this intro is sick.
Yo, this looks like really well made cartoon.
Whoa. I haven't seen this in forever.
God, man, these animation studios had money back then.
Yeah, this looks really good.
The economy on animation was different back then.
Yeah.
Dude, this is like a Halloween cartoon. This looks awesome.
Well, that Beetlejuice actually translates to cartoon pretty well because you can pull from just anything, right? You can just make just weird shit happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fast paced, good music. Crazy
dude,
animation.
It looks awesome.
Well, it's a little 3D.
Yo.
That was actually really
good.
This
one claps hard.
This might be the best intro we've seen so far.
This might be like a 9, 10.
At least a 9 for me. This is
9,
really
10.
Good.
This is like a 9 right here, dude.
Good pacing, good music, good animation.
Spend the money on the intro and then go cheap for the show. Yeah, you're probably right.
Probably true.
But that's the whole point of doing this, too, because we all know Thundercats is a 10. And the show the show does not play out quite like the intro. It's very snarfing in the kitchen, reading books.
Yeah, reading books with snarf.
They go easy on the show. The show is good too, people are saying though.
No, I don't remember much of the show, but that intro is crispy clean.
Mm. Yeah, that's a 9, 10. Easy. Rhinos, greatest show on Twitch. Thanks guys for all the amazing content. Help me get through this rough semester, dude.
Hey, get through it, man.
We're here for you.
You can do it.
You got this, Doug. Bear Country.
Big Bear Country.
This way to Bear Country. You'll know when you're there. As soon as you enter, you'll feel like a bear. A great grizzly.
So this was a Louie thing. When I'd go over to Louie's house, he had these books.
The Berenstain Bears books.
Yeah, I did not have these books. This was like a Louie. I see this and go, oh, that's a Louie house. That's Louie's house thing.
Hear me out. The reason why Louie's a furry is because of these books.
They are pretty anatomical. Louie said they kick
Tell
ass.
Me they're not like my first furry.
My first furry.
A Berenstain bear.
We are the Berenstain bears.
Louie, did you watch this?
Mister. Brother.
We appreciate each other.
We appreciate each other.
Oh!
In a split level tree. Mama, papa, sister, and me. Snuggest buddy.
Louis was a Berenstain
bear. Bareback Berenstain bear.
He was a Baron, bareback bro, Berenstain.
Bear
bro.
Here are more Berenstain
bears. We really appreciate one another.
I saw Bigfoot. Mama Bear, a baddie, said Louie.
Look at this terrible animation.
Mama Bear's a baddie? This looks like add some dark lighting here and we're in Five Nights.
And watch more.
They're cold, dead eyes, huh?
God. Dan and Janny to wrap it up.
That might have to go into the 4 pile for me. No, 3.
I was going to stick to 3.
Might be a 3 for me.
I don't ever want to watch that ever again.
You know what? You never have to.
Oh,
we went through it together.
All right.
Chat's giving us some
pretty
low
stuff. Yo, some Vice City vibes.
I'm seeing some zeros. You know, we haven't given out a 0 yet.
Oh, yes!
What the fuck is this? This rocks. Okay.
Woo! Hacker Man!
This reminds me of that comic book Arthur. What is it? Wait.
No, he has a robot girlfriend?
The fuck is this?
This looks sick.
Eating cupcakes and surfing?
Is this Barbie? What's that?
Dude! What the fuck, dude? Oh my god, look at this guy with his fucking
fuck
pants.
Yeah,
dude,
man.
Fuck
Stan
yeah.
Bush.
Look at that.
Woo!
Oh, they got that fucking cup design. Little fuck Jerry thing. The fuck is this? Beverly Hills Teens?
Best intro.
Oh my god, dude. Beverly Hills Teens. Intro's awesome. Pretty good.
Awesome.
Intro's pretty good. The intro's good, but I know I don't want to watch it.
All the shows dog shit.
I know I don't want to. Never heard of it. Never knew it existed. Dude, it exists. What are you guys giving it? 8s?
Sir!
I'll join the 8 club. It was a rocking, banging ass tune. People had their pants, leather pants with tiger stripes in it.
Yeah.
In a cartoon?
Rocking out with Stan Bush?
You never see that.
Nice.
Raven says, that's the best one ever. That man's a sex bot.
Yo, the dude hacked his own girlfriend into existence. Do you understand that?
And it was like an 80s robot.
And she had booba and everything. Yeah, my man was on another level.
You're like pointy. So that was, dude, that was.
Here comes Bigfoot to show off his stuff.
Oh, is this a monster?
Hey, man, brother. Yeah, Bigfoot. What? Muscle machine. Let's go, brother.
Bigfoot in the muscle machine.
Hell yeah.
Once he's rough and he's tough.
Bigfoot and the muscle machines.
Hell yeah, brother.
Wait, like Bigfoot or not like Bigfoot?
No, like the Bigfoot truck.
Get in a fight. He'll come to the rescue.
We're not ready.
Oh, he's going to have to kill him out.
When you need him, you know he's around.
Bigfoot, yeah.
He'll crush him and make him leave town.
Bigfoot and the muscle machines. They're big, bad, dirty, and mean. They're big, bad, dirty, and mean.
Oh, a show about a trucker, monster trucker guy.
That is K Kona out of 10. I'll tell you that much, buddy.
Chat, what are you thinking? Looks boring.
That show looks stupid.
Big, bad, dirty, and mean. Big, bad, dirty, and mean. Oh my god, that one was rough.
Oh.
But big, bad, dirty, and mean. Honk if you're gaming.
Oh,
big
someone's
and bad.
Someone's wants that cussy. Ah, I see what you guys are getting at.
Monster truck toys, though.
I mean, everyone had the Bigfoot thing that you drove, right?
Yeah.
I don't think they called them.
Yeah, yeah. That's 10.
Cars, I guess.
That top note, that big, bad, dirty, that's 10.
Nothing screams 80s like Bigfoot.
I don't know what the fuck that is.
Exactly.
I thought you were saying Bigfoot, like Bigfoot.
Yeah, exactly.
There's another Bigfoot?
Yeah, the Bigfoot, the truck.
It's a truck brand?
No, it's a monster truck.
Like Shamu, how he's not really...
There's like Gravedigger and the other guy and, you know?
No,
I don't. Power Wheels, that's right.
Oh, it's a Power Wheel thing. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, born in 91.
They're like wrestlers, but monster trucks.
Gotcha.
And then your favorite one.
Dildozer. Dildozer? Big, bad, dirty, and mean, that's for sure. I'll give it like a fucking 5. It was whatever.
It sucked. It was like a 5.
Hidden deep in a swamp lies tiny Biscuit Castle.
Home of the smallest dogs in the world.
Oh my god.
The Biscuits.
The Biscuits. Look at that one walk. So sassy.
And they ride frogs.
Oh. For years, kings have entrusted their royal
treasure puppies who ride frogs.
What?
What the fuck
now
is this?
From a nearby castle rules the wasteful King Max.
Wasteful?
Red-headed, red-beard lord.
This is some weird, like, Smurf with puppies thing.
Yeah, it's like gummy bears meet Smurfs?
Smurf puppies?
Wasteful, he wastes tomatoes.
Wasteful?
Check it!
Oh, yes, sire!
Yes, sir.
What the fuck?
Little puppy Smurfs who ride frogs through the swamp.
It has to be Smurfs. I'm getting Smurf vibes.
I've never heard of this.
Biscuits!
Biscuits!
Biscuits! Biscuits! It's got to be the same company.
You know what this was?
But, oh, yeah, I hated it. I did not like
this
Smurf.
This was all a cash grab for merchandise.
Oh, yeah.
This was just like Beanie. I'm assuming the toys were like Beanie Baby-esque.
Yeah. The way that the toy industry was, man, like, if you could take a mold of something
Pound
else.
Pound puppies, yeah.
If you could take a mold of another toy and just, oh, if we just repaint it and add
a
little hat. Oh, dude, we don't have to turn the factory down.
Put a dress on and put a hat.
We don't have to switch out the parts to the plastic toy creating factory. We just add the thing at the end where the hat goes on, the guy
but
paints it.
But we need a cartoon.
And there you go.
And it's a cartoon commercial.
Yeah, repaint. It's just a repaint.
Biscuits!
What are we giving? Biscuits a 3? I'm going to give it a fucking 3. I did not like that.
I'm giving a lot of 4s. I'm going to do a 4.5.
Queen Gore, I love you boys.
Hey,
you have great
you,
content
Queen Gore.
All the time. Thank you, dude. And where's Wildo? What up, dude? Oh, the 80s tech. With the Chrono spaceship.
John Blackstar, astronaut.
Practical.
Is swept through a black hole into an ancient alien universe. Trapped on the planet Sagar, Blackstar is rescued by the tiny Trobit people. In turn, he joins their fight for freedom against the cruel...
What happened to this guy? I've landed on some strange planet. Don't know what's wrong with these people.
Everyone's fine, but this one's...
Cool. Whoa, cool.
Is he naked?
Yeah, why is he butt-ass naked? Why's he got such cool armor up top and then just dick and balls?
He's like Shredder on top and then just like Gotchi guy on the bottom.
Who rules by the might of the Power Star. The Power Star is split into the Power Sword and the Star Sword.
Oh, God.
Why? And so with
He-Man, fucking get in line.
Wannabe He-Man.
Everybody's He-Man.
Sword in hand, Blackstar,
damn,
together
moves.
With his allies...
That lady!
Boopa.
...sets out to save the planet Sagar.
Oh, that transformation.
This is his destiny. I am John Blackstar.
Hi, John.
Hi. Name's John. John?
Hi, John.
Like, your last name's so cool. And John.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I have half the sword that's named after me.
It looks hard to use half a sword like that, too.
Yeah.
He's wiggling it. He's trying not to really, trying not to cut himself.
It doesn't even look sharp.
No, it's like a box, too.
Yeah.
80s, it's easier to draw, box it out, you know?
Yeah, He-Man looks at this dude and is like, I'm gonna fucking clap this dude's ass.
Yeah, He-Man's like, what? His name's John?
John? Hi, John.
Hi. John's lame. The bad guy was cool. And what's with those purple people? The purple dudes were cool. We are the purple people.
Trapped on the planet Sagar.
Of planet Sagar.
On planet Sagar.
Look at this version of Sleeping Beauty.
Oh, I like the dick nose dude.
On our planet, everybody's born with one appendage way bigger than it should be.
Some of us more lucky than the others.
Sir!
Toby has big toes. Earby has big ears. Noseby has big nose. Don't even ask.
Don't ask Dick.
Don't ask Richard what his thing is.
No, ask. Ask.
Don't ask him. Dickie Richard, don't ask him.
Come on, just, ask me.
Just know that we are all born different from one another. No one the same.
Just don't drop the soap around Dickie.
Tooth be his big teeth, as you can see.
Everybody has something big.
Ballsy.
Ballsy.
In turn,
Ballsy.
Everyone's so sad.
Big ears.
And some of us jealous of others.
Against the cruel overlord.
These guys bump it up to like a 6 for me. And this guy was cool as fuck.
Fucking big dick in the shadows.
Wants to harvest their large appendages.
Give me your meat.
The people of Sagar, their blood fuels my spaceship.
It's always something like that.
It's a potent fuel.
The fumes coming up. Look at him. Try to swing his fucking stupid sword around. His half sword. His love interest.
Together with his allies,
so
sets
bad.
Out to save the planet.
Oh, God. The guy turns from a pterodactyl to like a giant elf. Ugh.
Just stay a pterodactyl.
Nothing's
dude.
More 80s than a pterodactyl turning into a giant elf.
Yeah, just stay a pterodactyl.
With a loincloth and a big belt.
Sagar.
This belt's so big. What's the belt for, dude? You're in a onesie.
You're in a romper, dude. There's no pants to hold up.
Yo, when do you ever wear a belt with a romper? And then boots? Oh my God, dude. Where are you going after this?
Hi.
I'm Jonathan.
Fuck you, John.
Blackstar.
10 out of 10.
When you're feeling bored or blue, watch out for the munchies. They find
the munchies?
Oh, hey, wait, is this a, like a child obesity thing?
Wait, the munchies?
It is!
They make you munch when you're not hungry.
These... Yo. Oh, these are your inner demons telling you to binge eat!
Yo, I've been living with these fucking guys for the past 2 months.
I'm trying to get rid of these guys!
Dude, I am... These guys have been hanging out with me because I've been pigging out and it's not even fucking Thanksgiving yet.
Here, munch this.
Here, munch that.
Munch this, munch that.
Oh, they made him fat!
And they laugh at him!
Laughing
at him! What? What? This is a cartoon?
Look how fat he is!
This is shit.
He's trying to work it out.
He's trying to work out. Oh my god, this is exactly what I thought it was.
Watch out for the munchies. Another nutritional message from the ABC Television Network.
Bod Squad telling you not to be fat?
Yo, the Bod Squad's fat shaming?
Yo, 10 out of 10.
Oh, wow.
10 out of 10, dude.
Wow.
I want to eat with the munchies, you know?
They probably fucking, like, do the, you know, like, go from, like, place to place just getting just dank-ass shit.
Munch this, munch that. Those guys know where to get the good shit.
Oh, and then you smoke weed with those dudes.
Oh, my God. I want to follow those guys around. Someone say munchies?
What up, Loch Ness?
What's up, Loch Ness? Look at him having a skateboard, oh losing my the God. Weight. And he still has time for his hobbies. He's jump roping in the kitchen. I get yelled at about jump roping in the kitchen.
There's
knocking shit over.
There's something to say about working out in the kitchen, though.
Holding up cakes and turkey legs.
Eat it. Come on, join us. It's fun.
Yeah, this is an American cartoon.
Another nutritional message from the ABC Television Network.
Wow.
Surrounded by 5 servings of fruits and veggies. When I was a kid, it was all 5 servings of fruits and veggies. 5 servings of fruits and veggies.
Yeah, have we canceled fruit yet?
Not yet. The carrot, though, he's starting to act up. I'm going to give this one a fucking 10 out of 10.
That was amazing. That's at least an 8.
I wish it was, you know, in 4K, but what are you going to do?
Amazing.
Yo, 5 cats, what up, dude? Yo, what's with this one? It's always got a little attitude.
It's like Jacksepticeye. Whoa.
Brave Star? Brave Star.
Far away in a distant time.
Well, it's like Dune for kids. It's like Dune!
Whoa, and there's like slave people?
The carrier brush brought outlaws by the score.
Cool!
Whoa, dude.
Hell no. Yeah!
Cowboys in Space was fucking huge, dude.
Bring in Brave Star!
It's fucking huge.
And Bear.
Whoa.
Dude, he kicks ass.
Brave Star.
Yo!
Shooting from the hip.
Oh, he's a Native American superhero. This is awesome. This is awesome.
Oh,
look at the
man.
Horse.
Dude.
The horse fucks, dude.
He's a Native American dude. Yo, Thanksgiving dub. Dude, Native American rancher cyborg. They put the weirdest shit together in the 80s, man. Wait, what the fuck?
And a pro wrestling horse. Animorph.
Dude, this horse is like so 80s-y designed.
Hey, wait!
What's
going on? Boy, he's got a gun! Gun! Fuck!
It's actually owned by Marvel. Get him in the universe!
Dude, send him!
Yo, I want to see this guy in Shang-Chi hanging out.
Ten out of ten. I need to know more about Brave Star.
10 out of 10.
I need an origin story.
I gotta watch it. 10 out of 10. Ten out of ten.
That horse was awesome too. Something for the furry community.
He's winking.
Yes.
Might have been the first animatronic or anamorphic, whatever.
Does anyone know if the show's any good? It might be pretty bad.
Brave Star. About to find it. Yeah. I wonder if it's just like, is it on YouTube? The thing about some of these dudes, sometimes they're so just riddled with cobwebs.
Toys are cool too.
They're just kind of sitting around. Let me look it up. I mean, this is obviously a strong 10. Is it Brave Star with two R's?
Double R.
Brave Star. Why did it have two R's? They really couldn't get the copyright? It was super popular in Mexico?
Dude, it's awesome.
Season one, full episodes. It's fucking sitting here on YouTube. Dude, this guy's awesome.
They smoke
weed!
Oh,
they're getting fucking super high.
You see? Weird deputy!
Yo, this is uploaded in, like, really good quality, too.
Son.
Marshal Brave Star. What do you want?
I heard there were some fellas out this way robbing prospectors.
Bad fellas.
Robbing prospectors.
Let's get out of here!
Oh, my God.
Brave Star!
Let's see if that dingo can ride without his robot.
Dude, this
fuck
show
robot,
is
bitch.
This show's fucking sick,
Brave
dude.
Brave Star!
We're finally gonna have a chance to get even.
Shut your beak.
Hell Classy yeah. Packs!
Hell yeah.
And I want you to stay here and mind the camp while I'm gone.
Oh, so weird. Space cowboy shit, dude.
Whoa. This is really good quality.
Retrobytes? Is this the copyright holder? They might own this.
It's interesting.
Sometimes the copyright holder just puts it all up on YouTube and they just decide, we'll just make our money from people watching ads on YouTube at this point. Because fucking no one's signing up for Disney Plus because Brave Star's on that bitch. What do you got there, Popo? My God, that's sick, dude. Brave Star merch.
What do you think?
Just do full screen. No? Look at that toy, dude.
Nice.
The toy fucking stands up. His gut changes out. The attachments. Dude, he's sick. Brave Star's dope, dude. 10 out of 10. Reboot. Bring him in the MCU. Him and Shang-Chi. Hanging out.
Brave Star.
Oh, no.
Boing. Dude. And then everyone goes. It's just an audible.
Great. Jesus Christ.
Hey, the new Fat Albert show with Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids, plus the Brown Hornet.
The who? Bill Cosby was a superhero?
You'll have fun now with me and all the gang, learning from each other. Why would you?
This is Bill Cosby coming at you with music and fun. And if you're not careful, you may learn something before we're done. So let's get ready, okay?
Hey, hey, hey.
I did have no idea that there was a superhero, Cosby. Did you know that there was a Cosby superhero?
No. I'm kind of glad I didn't.
If you're not careful, you're going to learn. We don't want to learn stuff while we watch cartoons. Brown Hornet. With the short shorts.
All right.
Next Marvel adaptation?
You might want to hold your breath.
Yeah, I don't know about this Hornet. Yeah. Isn't there another Hornet? Let's get that other.
Green Hornet.
Let's get the green one. What about brown? I don't know.
Here you go.
Ew, what the fuck is this show? What the fuck?
Yeah. Sorry, Bill, but it's another 1-0.
Shame.
Whoa, bangers. Look at these two, dude. Bangers.
Elmer Fudd?
Oof. Is this just like classic Looney Tunes compilation show? You know what's cool about Looney Tunes, too? They have, like, uploaded 4K 8-hour compilations just on YouTube.
That's amazing.
Bugs Bunny and Tweety show.
Oh, they had, like, a variety show?
10. 10. Bad Albert Sugarfoot. 10. Fat Albert, thank you, dude.
Fat Albert, thank you, man.
He's like, it shows a 10. Fuck you guys. Thank you for the 5 gifted, dude. I mean, you got Bugs and Daffy with the... Come on.
It's going on a little long, though.
Nah, that's perfect. Oh, there it... Why Sylvester? Oh, there's like a mini Sylvester. Who's mini Sylvester?
Yeah, it was his illegitimate kid when he had all the sex with all those ladies.
Tonight, with the show. Is this just a way for them to air old cartoons?
I think so.
Cartoons?
Yeah.
This next one's a real stinker. It's like we got all these episodes with like smells, smelly, stinky stuff, and we put them all in one episode, and we'll just add some bumpers, and it's a new show.
Bugs Bunny and Tweety.
It's a 10. It's unfair. Show. It's a 10. Makes me want to go to Six Flags. It's a 10.
So, like, where do they have like a Looney Tunes like amusement park? Is that
Six Flags?
It'd be Six Flags, right?
Yeah. Right? Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, if you type like Looney Tunes 4K, yeah, you get these like four-hour... Wow. There's like four-hour compilation super HD all on
Six
YouTube.
Six Flags, yeah.
Six Flags, dude. Lola Bunny.
Crazy voice.
Looney Tunes Comedy Hour.
A whole hour. All right, this compilation's DMCA. We know it's a 10. We know it's a 10.
Oh, it's a callback to that.
It's a 10. And then, yeah. All of the Looney Tunes.
Classic.
Yeah. They did it a lot.
All right, can you pause real quick?
Yeah.
These are raisins. They're not kidney stones.
They're
okay?
Raisins.
They're raisins. They're not kidney stones. Jesus Christ.
What a weird, strange thing to be like, that's the idea.
What? This dried up old raisin?
That's the cartoon we're going to make.
They're not poops.
What about just like various fruits? One could be a banana. One could be an orange.
Banana man.
And then, you know, the deep voice. It could be like something, you know, robust, like an apple. And a grape could be like a little high-pitched voice.
No. All dried raisins.
All soulful raisins. No ordinary grapes. I don't like the poop shape.
The tall voice looks like a freshly spinched turd. What, does he play guitar?
Yeah, the bass is a real shitbag. Oh, they're
and
hot!
And the turdettes. There they are.
California raisins.
Dude, the sun looked cool as fuck, dude. His nose, dude.
Oh, well, why?
Oh, your wages are here.
Oh, they're getting dry.
Turn it, baby.
Like bumped butts.
Raisins. Oh, everybody else is a different fruit.
Dude, the cauliflower groupies want to suck their dicks, dude.
Boy, those cauliflower groupies, they're fucking wild, dude.
Cauliflower heads.
Yeah.
I'm a parsnip.
Parsnips, where are you guys at?
Parsnip it over here.
Parsnips, make some fucking noise. Yeah. Come on.
California Raisin Show. Yeah.
The intros has to be the best part of the show, because why the fuck would you watch this?
Turn ups, fucking turn up.
Raisin propaganda.
10.
Wow.
That's a 10.
See, the thing with raisins, either love raisins or you hate them.
Articus, you have a great comment in the live chat. How do you make a show about the California raisin? How do you...
You don't know the struggle of being a raisin, dude?
They have an episode... Can I?
Ew, they're talking to Pickle Queen.
Oh, they have every episode on YouTube.
Oh, Mama Raisin.
They have every episode. I'm just curious. What is
5 hours of raisins? Five hours, dude.
What is a typical structure of a story for a California raisin? The record label that owns the masters for the Cali Raisins also own the masters of Ice Cube's first solo album. That's like a fun fact that's just embedded so hard in your brain, huh? It's your boy. It's like one of those, you're never going to be able to let go of that one.
And then you talk to
it's a good
Ice Cube,
fun
he's
fact.
Like, fuck those raisins.
Oh, they practice their moves, so it's like them struggling to be, you know, make it in music.
Performers, okay. Mama Raisin's dummy.
Mama Raisin got those oatmeal raisin cookies. She got those. There.
You know what's funny is she has that apron to cover up her raisin tits.
She's covering up those nipples.
Otherwise, she would just have titties out.
Everybody go around the circle like a anonymous thing. My name's Fred. I'm an alcoholic. Yeah, my name's Ted. And I'm sexually attracted to Mama Raisin.
Mama Raisin just does something to me that no human woman could.
I am in a romantic relationship with Mama Raisin.
Hey, let me help you, Mom.
I'll take that, pretty lady.
Damn, everybody's like sweet to her, too.
Oh.
Kissing her sweet cheeks.
Oh, such good boys.
Oh, my boys.
May we escort you to your table, madame?
It's only in the left ear I'm hearing this show.
Wee, wee, Mom, Sherry.
What is it? So they flirt with Mama Raisin.
Hang on here. LB, how you doing, kiddo?
The turnip has got a deal. He's like their manager.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, so it's like, you know, fly to the Concords. It's like, we're going out, we're getting gigs, huh?
Yeah. With us, Mrs. X.
Yo, Mama Raisin keeps getting there.
Yo, look at those lips.
Good idea.
Yeah.
Something about the way she looks reminds me of that one superhero show with like the guy that kind of looked like SpongeBob and then the superhero guy.
I was going to say she looks like that lady from the Drew Carey show.
Me.
Go to New York? Oh my. Oh no. I couldn't really. I have so much to do around here. New York.
Oh. New York.
Mama, shut the fuck up.
Well, I wouldn't.
It's all about Mama Raisin?
Mama just Raisin. One.
Man, how are we gonna make Mama Raisin proud?
Oh.
And then do a musical number. Draw together.
Whoa, she winking at it.
And draw together. Yeah, this whole show is about Mama Raisin. And her thick dumper.
Raisin, Raisin.
So yeah, this is a typical episode. Then they get in a run with the cops. And then the apple guy takes them around town. And they...
And they hook up with a fig.
How do they get themselves into this situation?
The woman.
The eggplant.
Oh, he's tired. He's up all night fucking.
Yeah, slinging that eggplant.
He's throwing that eggplant around.
What's he doing?
Oh, God.
Ooh, oh, Miss Cauliflower.
You know, you smile so bright, you could have been a cauliflower. Could have been a cauliflower.
A street corner gig.
I hear you.
Yeah, it's the struggles of a musician. That's how you do it. Because I was curious, too. I was like, how the fuck do you make a whole goddamn show off of the premise that these raisins play music?
It's basically VeggieTales without the Christianity.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Their music's better, though. VeggieTales sucks.
Well,
VeggieTales music. Some of them clap, but it's mostly... but this is, like, good shit, dude. This is a 10.
Hi, it's Calliope time.
Who?
Excuse you?
I'm Gene, and this is Liza. She's a movie hound, and we just love to watch movies. Got some good ones today, and we'll watch together as soon as I pick up
movies.
All the letters you've written.
Calliope with your friends.
Calliope?
Gene and Liza is brought to you every Sunday at this time by USA Network.
Brought to you in part by...
What?
I don't know what the fuck that was. Given a zero.
That wasn't anything.
I was very confused. Oh, this song stinks.
Ew.
Oh, the song is...
Oh, is this the John Candy?
John Candy cartoon. God, the song is bad. I gotta turn it down. It's killing me. Oh, it's like
some guy.
Camp Candy. Hey,
yeah, John Candy didn't know any musicians. Wasn't he like a huge star?
Yo, call the Raisins up.
He didn't know anybody? He could come in and sing a better intro? Because the show, like, animation-wise, looks really good.
Yeah, the animation looks decent. This song is awful.
It's so bad. It's so bad. It sounds like drunk idiots who can't fucking sing.
Hey, I love and respect John Candy. I think he's a great comedian. Terrible singer.
Ugh. I'm sorry, this theme, I have it as low volume as I can stand it. It's so bad, I want to give this like a 1.
Ugh.
The intro, if we're basing this on intros, ugh, that is so bad, I have to give it a 1. It's so fucking bad, dude.
And still going.
Chuck KD. If you want issues, K to play. I gotta pee real quick, and I gotta just not listen to that guy singing for a second.
Oh. Hurry up! Candy, wrap it up! Oh. So is this guy just like... he's a...
Teen angels from his prehistoric block of glacier ice.
Whoa, those ladies.
First superhero, Captain Caveman.
So he's a superhero. Dee Dee!
Hilarious and sometimes scary mystery missions.
So it's just a weird excuse to do the same premise as Scooby-Doo, but with ladies. All right.
Ready.
That sucked. What is this?
I'll be your captain.
All right.
Come follow my dream. I'll lead the way with a bright cosmic beam. Show you wonders in space that you've never seen.
See, the song is a banger, but the intro sucks because it's just all text. It's all these, like, it's Thomas A. White. Oh, it's anime. Sky! Pirate ships in space. Edgy pirate space pirate show.
Whoa, what is this?
The banger of a song.
What was that?
Take to the sky!
What was that? Is this still it?
This might still be it. I don't know. It didn't really say what the
What'd
show
you give
was.
It? What would you give that one?
Captain, what?
What would you give
Captain
that?
Captain Harlock? The song is really good, but it's disrupted by credits.
Oh, I see. What is it called?
Captain Harlock? A simple space pirate who fought for Earth.
Captain Harlock.
Sup?
Huh. He looks kind of cool.
Yeah, it could be cool. The intro is awesome.
Videoland. Metroid, Castlevania.
Metroid.
Congo Land.
Welcome to Video Land.
Mega High.
My.
Wake up, Kid Icarus.
Whoa, Kid Icarus.
Welcome to
Oh, is this like Video Game Land?
I think it's Captain N. Yeah.
Mother Brain.
His
voice cracking.
Oh, that crack, huh? Yeah, Captain Annie's interacted with all the Nintendo IPs.
The ultimate warp zone.
It's like a kid gets sucked in, yeah. Play with the dog, play with the dog, play with the dog.
Kevin, I thought I told you to clean up your room.
I've never seen this.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Yeah, I tried looking at some of it to dub it, but it's just so... It's fucking awful.
Awesome. No!
To get sucked into his Nintendo.
Captain N.
And he has a fucking Nintendo gun.
The Game Master.
The Game Master.
That's pretty pog.
The idea, super cool.
Yeah.
So weird how bad everything looks. Like, that's Pit.
Is that supposed to be Simon Belmont?
I don't even know. They made everyone look so weird, and that's Mega Man. Yeah, it's the Mega Man is so fucked.
Hi, I'm Mega Man.
Like, even if I wanted to dub it, I couldn't even be like, I'm Mega Man, because people are like, well, I'd be dubs. You make it up shit.
Yeah.
It's not even fucking Mega Man. Well, it was.
Captain N, the Game Master.
It's a cool concept for a cartoon.
Yeah, the concept is cool, but the fact that they fucked everything up, and then they did the real life getting sucked in the TV.
Yeah.
I'll give this like a 7.
Six.
Like a 7. This is a cool idea, but it just was not good. Very bad.
Captain OG Reedmore here. An ordinary sidewalk on an ordinary day. But did you ever stop to think that you could get away? Take a journey on a rocket. Take a voyage on a ship. Just read a book and off you go, because reading is a trip. Explore a tropic jungle.
Going for reading.
Ooh. You're losing me.
Planet. Oh, reach the glacier's tip. Just read a book and off you go, because reading. Yes.
Hey, that's not a cartoon. This is just a commercial telling me to read books.
The Library of Congress made cartoon commercials.
I'm not reading shit.
Wait, so this is government propaganda to make me read books?
I ain't reading shit. Avery Senpai, y'all still check SpeakPipe? I left one the other day.
I'm going to be honest with you, dude.
Thank you, dude.
I don't even know where to look that up.
Reading books?
Is a trip.
I don't know. That's not even a cartoon. It's a bumper.
Care Bear.
Oh, boy.
Let's count down. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Who's that coming from somewhere up in the sky? Moving fast and bright as a firefly. Just when you think that trouble's gonna pounce, who's gonna be there when it really counts? To that Care Bears countdown, and send a wish out through the air.
And send a wish out through the air.
Just do that Care Bears countdown. Just when you need them, they'll be there.
Just when you need them, they'll be there.
Don't be afraid when clouds are brewing in your heart. Can dream, just send a wish out in the dark.
And do that Care Bears countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Great performance.
Damn, bro, 10.
That dude was singing out that Randy Newman sound alike.
Yeah. Legitimately a 10. And it's, I remember even being a kid looking at this, being like, it looks like a girl show, because it's all cute and lovely and cuddly.
They have heart.
And then the intro would come on, and be like, well, I guess I'll watch it. I mean, all
right, you know.
I guess I'll stick around at the preschool and I'll watch it. I guess I'll watch
it. But if someone walked in on you while you were watching this, you'd be like,
where's the remote?
Oh, I'm trying to watch Gummy Bears.
Where's the remote?
Gummy Bears?
Someone hit the remote. Lalelule, bro. Thank you, dude.
I remember this.
I can't tell what's going on.
That lady, dude! Hey. Oh my god, dude!
And my glasses.
Oh.
The competition doesn't stop. Mixing with the ladies' fancy.
Wait, are they naked?
You're into this?
Dude. Oh, are you telling me you're not?
Those animators knew what they were doing.
I smell catnip.
Yeah.
Cats and Company.
In Comic Sans? You go through all the...
It's not like centered.
I guess they lost it and they had to make their own. And actually, the song was clapping, right?
Yeah, shout out to the furry community. I'm sure a lot of people discovered themselves with this cartoon. So I think it was a very formidable show for a lot of people in this generation.
Charlie Austin, 8.
Furry.
8. Me too, dude.
Nice! Oh, wait, are we gonna read?
Oh, they're rotoscoping kids in there?
Oh.
Yeah, the furry origin story. The fuck is this?
The rotoscope is crazy.
Dinosaurs, look!
This is a story break moment reminding you to read books, children.
Stop watching cartoons and read a book.
Remember that cartoons rot your mind.
In the near future, Doc Terror and his cyborg companion Hacker
yes!
unleash their forces to conquer Earth.
Oh, awesome.
Force can stop this
dude, that's me and all my friends.
Dude, that's us. Yeah, yeah. I'm the blue one. I'm the blue one.
I'm the one with the mustache.
I'm the blue one. I'm the red one.
Brave men.
Brave men.
In specially created exoframes, they can be transported anywhere.
Nice.
To fuse with incredible assault weapon systems.
Oh, they got some good toys here. Yeah, look at that Chewbacca.
And Deedee. Deedee read the terminal. Read the console. Like they know.
Yeah, the orangutan instead of Chewbacca. Right, Chewie?
Right, Tang?
Yo, fresh hot cookies. Thank you for the brand new Prime.
Hey, new sub in the chat. Thank you, man.
Hey, Bobo, go ahead and be a doll. And would you go over there and grab me the... Never mind, I'll do
Not
it.
Not that one, no!
I'll do it myself.
Beam down from the space station Sky Vault. Becoming Mammal Machine.
Fuck yes!
Get my attachments in!
Get kid!
Max Ray, brilliant sea operations commander.
He's the king of the sea.
Dudes, think of the toys.
Jake Rockwell, rugged land operations specialist.
Rugged on land.
Fuck!
I'm going in.
Ace McCloud, daring air operations expert.
McCloud.
Yeah, air attack.
Whatever the challenge, they are
Take
ready.
That, ISIS!
The Centurions.
Centurions, form one. Power extreme.
You like that, Deedee?
You like the dog reading the computer? Got him.
She likes it. It's a 10. That top note, pure vanilla. That cream. It's got that 80s perfect, that the attachments are so perfect to make toys.
Yeah.
Everybody's saying 10.
Power extreme.
I don't even know what power extreme is, but I want it.
Don't even need to put the E in the beginning of that bitch.
Ooh. Bots?
Oh.
Yeah!
Go-Bots!
That's so
Go-Bots! Let's Go-Bots!
Let's Go-Bots! Let's Go-Bots! So what's the difference between this and Transformers?
Transformers way better.
Is this
way better?
Did this come after and phoned it in? Is it the whole story? I
think so.
I didn't really either have a chance to watch either of those. I watched Beast Wars was
Ooh,
my
yeah.
time. I missed Transformers and I missed whatever the fuck GoBots is. This is Walmart Transformers. Okay.
Oh, he was riding that kid.
GoBots were before.
Whoa.
Were they?
I don't know.
GoBots were more of a local drugstore.
Let's go, bots!
They look so dumb.
These guys were first? Okay.
All right.
It's so like just stick people. Challenge
of the GoBots.
Bodega bots.
I mean, what are we giving this one out of 10?
The theme song's pretty dope.
GoBots, let's go, bots.
It's not
Transformers.
Like, it's like 7.5.
Whoa, generous. I'm thinking like Son of Chiba. I'm thinking 5.
Okay.
I'm thinking 5
let's
on this
go,
one.
Let's go, bots. Let's go, bots.
They weren't doing anything cool.
I turned into a fucking plane.
Yeah, he did. Oh, shit.
Bezos!
Are 13 of the most sinister villains of all time.
Bizarro.
Legion of Doom.
Legion of Doom.
To a single objective, the conquest.
So I really
universe.
Liked the Only Suicide Squad. Like, a Legion of Doom could actually be kind of sick.
They're always going to fuck it up.
Super Friends.
Super Friends. Look at all their friendships.
Bruce.
Hawkman.
Solomon Grundy. Iceman.
Brave Star.
Who's that lady?
10 out of 10. This is 10 out of 10. It's crazy as fuck what's going on. Whoa. Right.
Meow.
Right.
Catwoman.
Oh, I saw that guy like so stupid with the big fishbowl head.
Oh, yeah. The Seaman's art.
Seaman. Unhand me.
He's literally being like fucking fucked by an octopus.
Mm-hmm. This is the challenge of the Super Friends.
Black Manta.
Goro's
right.
In there too, dude. Black Mantis, yeah.
Challenge.
10 out of 10.
That's pretty cool.
10 out of 10. It's like,
it's classic.
Insane to think. I mean, these were big back then, but to know where they are now, it's like, fuck, dude. Back then, I was like, yeah, this would be cool. We'll do like a superhero show. Some kids will like it, I guess.
Yeah.
Now it's fucking everything.
I mean, this is like the ultimate crossover before there was ultimate crossovers.
Yeah, this is the Schneider cut. Yeah, dude.
All right.
Yeah, dude. We're the boomers right now. The boomers are like rocking their necks. You know, boomers like not too hard, but they're like rocking back and forth. Just be.
Big sub.
Thank you for the big sub.
Did they ever do the Rugrats when they're grown up version of this?
Ew.
Like Charlie Brown found himself.
Charlie Brown's working in an office. So boomery. They tried.
Oof.
Kenny's rocking.
Hell yeah, brother. Rocking my rocking chair.
People in a wooden chair watching this right now, rocking. It's going to take him a while.
Hurry up.
Charlie Brown and Snoopy show. 28, never watched this. I feel like this is before 80s. I swear were like way before.
This show, this version. Charlie Brown and Snoopy might be 80s, okay. But like.
Yeah, is this 60s,
way before
huh?
That, yeah.
All right, yeah, I was going to say 60s. This is a super cut.
I don't know the year of this specific cartoon show.
Yeah, no, boom, boom, boom. What are you going to give this? Charlie Brown. If it ain't the Christmas special or the Great Pumpkin special, yo, I don't know.
It's, I mean, it was a lot of that wah-wah-wah, right?
Yeah.
And a lot of talking to Lucy and just getting bad advice.
Yeah.
Getting the, you know, the pull of the football.
I like that stereo sync. A 7 for history. A nice,
that's
honorable
most...
7 for history.
Oh, that's boomery, man.
7 for the boomers. And then this comes on? What the fuck?
Oh, yes.
Should we risk it for the biscuit?
It's risky.
Sorry, VOD gang, if it gets cut out.
You'll know why.
Gumshoes are picking up the slack. There's no case to be going.
This is so good. Damn,
dude. Probably the best intro we've seen so far. It's better than I remember.
Is that our first 11, right?
That's better than I remember.
Is that our first 11 out of 10, Kenny? And it's our first 11.
Great use of an amazing song.
Wow.
An amazing song.
Wow.
And then it was a montage of the best moments of Chip and Dale.
Fucking wow, dude.
Ugh.
Setting the bar high, Chippy Dale.
Ugh.
I never watched the cartoon, but I did play the video game. We rented that a few times.
Everything's great.
Did rent it a few times.
Everything's great.
Lalalule, bro. Thank you again. And Dad Sandy's coming in. Chip and Dale. He says 11 out of 10. You got to name
it.
You got to name a sandwich after these boys.
Ooh, the Chip and Dale.
Yo, Dad Sandwiches runs his sandwich shop. I'll never forget. Dude, there's the idea right there. Mm-hmm. The Chip and Dale sandwich. It's two sandwiches. It's one sandwich, two sides, different things.
Yes. Oh, I've never had that. Think of a sub.
You order a sub, but it's cut in half, and the other half is one, and the other was another kind of sandwich.
Oh, I actually kind of like that.
Looks like us. It's me and Pops right there.
Am I the weird dude?
Mm-hmm. There's the idea. You know, they always have the sandwiches named after people. There it is, Dad. Dad Sandy's.
Yo, Dad Sandy, shout outs, man.
Thank you for the tier 3, my man. Our first 11 out of 10.
That was a really good one, man.
Cartoon?
I think we found our second 11.
Norris.
Fuck!
He's hitting me through the screen. Watch out, chat.
Of action. Chuck Norris stars in...
Yes!
Whoa. That's pretty good.
Chuck Norris. He's got nerves of steel and strength to match.
There's your boomer show. Look at him, though, dude. He's wearing his socks.
Barefoot?
He's like, got socks on? He's barefoot?
Whoa!
Chuck Norris with his team. Pepper.
Wait, so is the cartoon Pepper. Like he is Chuck Norris?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dangerous. His acting has helped get him accustomed to just saving the world naturally.
Through his
ass kicking.
Okay.
What? Too much.
Too much.
Wait, what is that Samurai kid doing warrior. That song?
Too much.
Reed, Chuck's teenage apprentice. Tabe, a sumo champion.
Tabe!
He's got a badge on his dick.
Yo, dude, whoa. Hide your wife when Tommy walks in the room. Big time Tommy.
Big time Tommy coming in. Take it easy.
Norris, they battle the sinister forces of the claw.
Remember this.
Oh.
This guy? Jeff Bezos with the claw?
Think about it. The toys. We just crank out G.I. Joe's just pop one arm off and put a fucking robo arm on.
And the ruthless super ninja.
Finish Norris.
Chuck.
Don't have to animate his mouth.
I'll get you, Chuck.
Norris stars in Chuck Norris Karate Commandos.
Ooh, the K, the Mortal Kombat K. Okay.
Chuck, you might want to talk to Mortal Kombat to get some residuals, dude.
Because it's the Chuck, he's always down to fuck. I'm going to give there like an 8.
That was pretty awesome. I was going to say 8.5.
You hear that? 8? Karate Commando.
Very loud, sorry.
Buttons and Rusty?
What?
Which is which?
The biggest, reddest dog in history.
Okay, that was a non-commercial thing. And then we have Clifford, which is making a comeback.
I can't believe it.
They're making a Clifford movie.
Is there no original ideas anymore? Did Clifford, we run out?
You can count on Clifford for fun and adventure and mystery.
Another one of like, how do they make a cartoon of this? It's like Dave Chappelle said. Every book's the same. Look at the dog. He's big. And then it's over.
Yeah.
dad's like, so what is the cartoon? Wow, your dog's really big.
But I mean, nothing like scream like the Blue Fairy. This is all just propaganda to begin with.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Oh, it keeps going.
Really? This long of an intro for Clifford? This tape is cursed, yeah. Every time I see the tracking like this, I feel like the VHS went through like a landfill, went through the trash system, and ended up in a thrift store somehow, and someone bought it, put it in a machine, hit record, transferred it to CD. CD in a computer and burned it to a
and then uploaded
it on
it.
YouTube.
Yeah.
The journey it had to take.
I never liked Clifford.
I'm going to give Clifford like a 3.
I didn't get it.
It's going to have a 3.
I get it was popular. I just didn't get it.
Comic strip? Come on, take a trip on the comic strip. What the fuck? That was like Thundercats animation quality. What the fuck was that?
Where's Karate Cat?
He's mean, he's lean, a karate machine.
Kyo, baby.
The mini monsters are your...
Oh my god, a monster show? I'd have been all over this. This looks fucking awesome.
Oh, is this like different cartoons together?
Yeah, this looks like a Kablam kind of thing.
Yeah, okay.
Weekly variety cartoon.
Minimon's the answer. And who can do hip-hop better than a...
Yo, Ninja Turtles.
Dude, these guys look dope.
Frog Gang, get down.
Frog Gang.
Street Frogs.
And hold on for exciting action and underwater adventure with the Tiger Sharks. All coming up on the...
C-O-N-I-C-S-T-R-I-B.
I think I just fell in love.
This kind of has everything.
I'm about to give this a fucking 9, almost a 10. That was dope. I don't even know what the fuck any of those are, but it was sick.
It makes you want to watch it.
Yeah, dude, that was a straight up 9.
That was really cool.
I loved the variety shows, the Kablams, the Oh Yeah cartoons.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah cartoons.
Oh yeah.
Kablam, Oh Yeah cartoons. And then there was another one I feel like that I would watch on Cartoon Network.
What?
Dude, this guy dick and balls just hanging out?
What's Martin Short
Sorry
doing?
If you saw Pee-wee's dick and balls. Oh, it's Martin Short. What is this dab thing he's doing? Oh, the hair. Ugh. What the fuck is going on? I feel like I've done drugs at this point. Yeah, is this Discount Pee-wee? That's what I was thinking. Ed Grimley?
Less is more. Scuff Pee-wee.
That was disgusting, huh? Well, that's not Pee-wee. Good. No.
No.
It's Ed Grimley. Martin Short doing the voice. He was from SNL?
I think it might be a Second City thing and like and SNL as well.
Grimley? Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to give that like a fucking 3, dude. I don't know what the hell's going on. The only thing that makes me curious is it looks like such a dumpster fire. I kind of want to see how bad it is, but...
Yeah, it looks like it's all over the place.
You know it's not going to be good when you do. Whew.
Cops.
Oh, yeah, dude. I was thinking about doing this one, and then I tested it out. I think it's got copyright on it.
Central Organization of Police Specialists.
fighting crime in a future time, protecting Empire City from Big Boss.
Because it's like that Captain Planet kind of feel, but it's, imagine if you made it more like Bad Boys, Bad Boys.
Yeah. Show looks cool.
Yeah, I've never seen this, and when I saw the trailer for this the first time, I was like, yo, this looks good.
I've never seen this before.
Animation on the intro is good.
Oh, awesome. Cool, super, guns!
Super evil gadget. Go-go gadget, dude.
Inspector Gadget.
Cops. Dino Dog. Whoa.
Damn.
She's strong. No problem. My laser RPG will take care of you.
This is a 10. This is crazy good.
This is everything. Brano.
Very 80s to have the exposed brain guy.
Yeah.
My brain's always hanging out in a jar.
I don't know why having your brain out is like an advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Sick.
It's crime fighting time.
Crime fighting time.
Got him.
That's a 10.
Easy a 10.
That's a 10.
Cool music, cool animation, awesome action, interesting characters.
Yo, Refrigerator Hung Like an Elf. All you guys. Thank you so much. Should we do one more, huh?
One more.
And then I gotta grab something to eat. Losing steam here.
No time!
Castle Dracula, home for many centuries to a dreadful dynasty of vicious vampire ducks. The Counts of
Dude, I've
Dracula.
Seen this pictures of this, but I've never seen the intro.
All beings can be destroyed by a stake through the heart
awesome.
Or exposure to sunlight.
Cool.
This does not suffice, however, for they may be brought back to life by means of a secret rite that can be performed
fucking
once
Satan.
A century when the moon.
Fuck!
Did this guy have anything to do with, like, Looney Tunes? Because he's drawn like that, but I don't think he is, like, related to that shit at all, is he?
Moon is in the eighth house
nah.
Blood.
Blood.
The latest reincarnation did not run according to plan.
Danger Mouse.
Oh, he used ketchup instead of blood.
Castlevania.
In the heart of Transylvania, in the Vampire Hall of Fame, yeah.
Got him.
Yo.
Yo, accurate zombie lore?
Count Dracula, sick.
Satanic
dude.
Blood rites?
Makes me kind of want to look. See, that one I actually want to look it up now and see, like, what the hell is going on.
Ooh, imagine a Halloween dub with this dude.
Woof. That shit looks good. There's your answer. Yeah, this looks good. What a good cartoon intro to go out on.
Awesome
we still have so
stuff.
Much more of this. We're gonna dip into these. Maybe you know we'll knock them out, but there's a lot. And then we gotta get into 90s cartoon intros, dude. Refrigerator Hebrix, thank you, dude, for the bits. All of you, thank you for being here today. Thanks for hanging out. It's fun to look at the Game Awards stuff, get the hype going.
Yeah.
So many good ideas, things we want to get to. Oh, my God. Don't forget, next Tuesday, what is it, the 23rd,
yeah.
12 hours, charity stream.
Yeah.
Be here for the charity streams. Come on through, hang out. We're going to be on all day playing party games. Going to be a lot of giveaways, too.
A lot of giveaways.
Incentivize some donations to a good cause, St. Jude's.
Mm-hmm.
So, if, you know, got a couple bucks, come by. Good cause. Might win something cool. Never know.
And for a good cause.
For the kids.
Yeah.
So, yeah, don't miss it. That'll be next week.
New schedule.
Yeah, we're doing the 2 to 5 thing.
looks like sometimes 2 to 6. That's just how it works out sometimes.
Hey, sometimes you have fun. You just want to keep going.
Sometimes it keeps going. It's good. But yeah, thank you guys so much. Charity stream, let's fucking go. Yeah, dude, yeah, 12 hours on the 23rd. 12 hours on the 23rd. 12 hours on the 23rd.
And then are we going to try to do a Chatsgiving?
We're going to try. We're going to see how we're feeling after that 12 hour.
Yeah, we're going to see how we feel.
Yeah. This is fun, though. I love looking back at the old stuff. It's cool to... And the show suggestions on the Discord, you guys were saying some cool shit.
Thank you, guys.
Someone said 80s cartoons, so thank you for the suggestions. Love doing the commercials, too, but it's nice to get some more variety.
Speaking of variety, our Tuesday, we're trying to aim for making it an extra special with, like, IRL content and, like, things like that. So make sure you're following the channel if you're new.
Yeah, Tuesday is always going to be super show. Super video podcast-y, talk show-y kind of vibes more. But, yeah, dude, we'll see you guys tomorrow, huh?
Tomorrow. Let's be there. 2 p.m. PST tomorrow. Schedule change.
Wait, can I get one more thing for you guys before we go?
What are you doing?
I want to get some...
Oh, yeah, we definitely need this. Don't leave yet. Don't leave yet.
I want to see if I can find something cool here.
Chat, also, make sure you're following me on Instagram, Djibouti Pops. Also follow Justin, Djibouti Justin. All right, chat, prepare yourself.
Happy New Year!
Give me one that's not a new year. Give me a... Let's leave with...
What? Ew!
Let's leave with some advice for the day.
I still can't see a thing! When's this eclipse coming? I don't even know where to soap up!
Well, I wanted like a Tommy tip of the day, thought of the day.
Baby, gonna lose some weight. Gonna lose some weight. Going to the gym.
Yes.
First day at the gym. Yeah, gonna hit them weights. Gonna hit that bike. Gonna lose some weight. It's locked.
Oh, gonna.
It's 24-hour fitness.
Think it is.
How could it be locked?
Fitness.
Are you kidding me? This is the reason why I'm fat.
I like the breathing.
Whoa.
All right. Well, hey, there's our there's your Tommy of the day thing. You never know.
Make sure to take it easy.
You never know. We'll catch you next time, chat.
OS by Live.
Keep it OS and take it easy. Take it easy.
This is a good stream.
You take it easy. Come on, please. Yo, chat, take it easy. You don't got nothing to please me. Come on, chat, dance with me. Yeah, baby, let's get groovy. Take it easy.
Shout out to everyone in chat. Love you guys. Thank you guys for all the support. And Twitch Primers. Make sure you use your Twitch Prime. You have to use it every single day. Thank you.
Damn. Keep it OS. I'm talking old school. Yeah, just like that. All right. Yeah, that's good. Catch you guys next. Bass. Oh, man, this song's jamming.